Hi, I'm Steve from the Rooted Podcast, and I hope you can join me every weekday for a 5 minute or less devotional, word study, or insight into Scripture to add to your day. Welcome to Fruit Snacks. Hey everyone. In this Bible background episode, I wanted to look at a people group that are referenced throughout the New Testament, but that we may not know that much about, and that is the Samaritans. Why were they so poorly treated or looked down upon in Jesus' day, almost as if they were second-class citizens? And why is it such a big deal that the woman at the well was a Samaritan? And in her conversation with Jesus, talks about whether or not we should worship on the mountain or in the temple and all these other things. This is all part of a shared heritage between the Jewish people and the Samaritans. Now, historically, things are a little bit murky because almost like the Hatfields and the McCoys, the Samaritans and the Jews have separate historical sources, separate documents in antiquity, and they often conflict or contradict. And so it's hard to exactly know who is telling the truth and who is just crafting a polemic against the other group. But from what we do know, we can piece together a few things. Samaritans were first mentioned during the time of Nehemiah and in the book of Ezra in the Old Testament, when after the conquest, the Jewish people came back from exile to begin to rebuild the temple that was destroyed when they were taken captive. And the people, or part of the people who were living in the land at the time, were the Samaritans. Now, it is generally considered common knowledge that the Samaritans were part Jewish, part pagan, because of the practice in the ancient world of mixing and matching people groups from all over a conquered area to reduce the ties to the land and to make rebellion less of an option for them. And so what resulted was, in part, the Samaritan group, which were essentially looked down upon in Jesus's day as half-breeds because of their mixed heritage. Now, the checkered history of the Samaritans and the Jews comes from the fact that during the rebuilding of the temple in the book of Ezra and during the time of Nehemiah, it was the Samaritans, among others, who opposed the rebuilding of the temple. And throughout the prophets in the Old Testament, references to the Samaritans are often tied to idolatrous practices, worshiping other deities, foreign gods, and embracing loyalty and worship to lesser spiritual beings than Yahweh. Obviously, that would have created great conflict between the Jews and the Samaritans, especially when the Jews were seeking to reestablish worship to the one true God. But during the Maccabean period, which occurred during the so-called silent years between the Old and New Testaments, the Samaritans also sided with the Jewish people's enemies during the revolt that broke out during the Maccabean period. And obviously, that did not do anything other than fuel more animosity between these two groups. And so by the time you arrive at the time of Jesus with the conversation with the woman at the well, you can see how all of this shared history and this built-up tension over generations would result in these two groups pretty much hating each other. So the fact that Jesus was willing to talk with a Samaritan woman was in and of itself a big deal. But even more of a big deal was that one of the sources of conflict, whether or not worship should occur in the temple or somewhere else, like the mountain that the Samaritans worshiped on, which was one of the old high places. Jesus says to her, none of that matters. There's going to come a time where it won't matter where people worship, only how they worship and how their heart is. And that also would have been a big deal. So understanding a little bit of backstory about the shared history of these groups helps us dial in a little bit better on the context and the real importance and impact of Jesus' words to the woman at the well.